here with Bryce Fisher. He's the head coach of Team Nova Scotia, and they will be competing at the 2018 Football Canada Cup in Calgary, Alberta. Bryce, thanks so much for joining
us. Thank you for having me, Amita.
Bryce, first question. Anybody that doesn't know about your coaching and playing career, can you give them a little bit of background as to who you are?
So, grew up in London, Ontario. Played high school football there, and then played Beefeaters after that, and then came out here to Halifax at St. Mary's University. Played there from 7 to 11. After playing career, then went on to kind of just get involved with stuff at Football Nova Scotia, coaching our U16 teams at the Spalding Cup, which was in Quebec. For those kind of 2 years there, was doing that. And then I believe it was 14 where I went on to be the DC of the Team Nova Scotia U18 team at the Canada Cup in Saskatoon. And then for those next couple of years was just doing U18s until last year was the head coach my first year. Brief period in there where I was DC at St. Mary's. 14 and 15 and kind of just as of right now it's just U18 and Football Nova Scotia as the job of the director of excellence pathway, so both of those kind of hand in hand, pretty well tied together to kind of get our athletes to where we want them to be to go to the next level.
So Bryce, let's talk about the 2018 version of Team Nova Scotia. Can you tell us what to expect in Calgary, Alberta at the Football Canada Cup?
As of right now, we're just really looking to compete. I mean, our biggest thing in this province is we have a good group of guys who are going in to compete. We tell them that this is basically their resume builder to go to the next level. The best way to do that is for them to be prepared both mentally and physically to put a good showing on and to compete versus every province that we play. Our biggest thing is for them to be prepared in all those situations so when it comes to the field, the score kind of takes care of themselves. So we're telling them that they really need to just be honed in on the small things so when we're going onto the field, when it's those high pressure environments, that the small things are stuff that they are not thinking about, so like alignment stance and those small things. So everything's fine tuned up until that point, and then when we're competing, we're just competing in a one-on-one situation.
Bryce, let's talk about the offense. Who are your quarterbacks and how are they similar and how are they different when it comes to their playing styles?
Oh wow, I wish our OC was here to answer that question, but our quarterbacks this year are Alan Young and Lucas Brocklehurst. Both of them have very, very high capabilities of kind of throwing downfield. A lot of good athletic abilities in both of them. I think their only differences would be left-handed, right-handed at this point. They're both different in that capability, but both very athletic guys, knowledgeable of the game, but they're just progressing every day. Every day we have with them, they're progressing in and out. So it's more about getting them more the mental preparation than the physical at this point, just because that's something where they're not taught as much in their high school levels that they are taught here, is to get them on the whiteboard and in the film room so they can prepare mentally more than physically at this point.
And as for the offense, what can we expect? And can you also name a few players to watch?
I don't really want to say what you can expect. I mean, our biggest thing, as I said before, Amita, is just competing. We got a great group of guys who have been together for a while now, and we're just kind of piecing things together. So as of right now, I don't even really know what to expect. Some good guys to kind of watch out for were guys that were in this tournament last year. Dawson Kierstead, Riley Felix are two guys as receivers. We're really kind of expecting some big things out of them. Jaden Simmons as a running back, some big things out of them. And a couple of our old linemen, kind of Logan Scott, Nick Baumhauer, guys like that have been there for a while, and some new guys coming in that kind of surprised us through the training aspects of our program. Like your Mark Hamlins, our Cornell Reddicks, a couple guys that kind of should really show some things. Ben Harrington, I mean, out of all of them, they're all going to kind of surprise, I think, a lot of people. That's just kind of to name the few. If I could name all of them at this point, I would. But obviously, that we don't have a lot of time to do that.
Let's go to the flip side, defense. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Our defensive schemes, kind of, we threw a lot at these guys. We threw it at them pretty fast. We're teaching kind of a very university style defense where these guys are kind of expected to know multiple fronts, multiple things. I think it may have got us into a little bit of trouble during the New Brunswick games, but at the same time, now they kind of understand what's expected of them. Our defenses pretty much fly around pretty well, and then kind of throw in multiple coverages, multiple blitzes, multiple fronts. So very excited to see what they can kind of do from there. We had a very good group last year, and we're kind of blessed with the same thing this year, is where we can have a bunch of different looks and not lose that much out of it.
How important of a role is special teams going to play in this tournament for Nova Scotia?
Special teams is always going to be an important role in any game when you're playing Canadian football. Our special teams coordinator, John Sveck, has put a lot of time into it, and we emphasize special teams very heavily in the tournament. You can win a game by 1 point, you can win a game by 2 points, and those games can always be won on special teams. So we got a lot of good special teams in throughout our entire process, and we have some very good guys on special teams that can contribute in that aspect. So always a high one. Our special teams coordinator definitely kind of emphasizes special teams when we're in practice. So we spend probably a good one third of the practice just doing special team stuff, and everything else is geared towards kind of really the main three aspects, and that is including special teams. So,
Bryce, how many returning players do you have coming back this year?
Oh, wow. I don't really know. I would say probably a good like 8 to 15 returning guys. It's hard to really say. There's so much going on right now that I haven't really kind of delved into that just specific question, but I'd say a good number of kids are returning from last year. It's hard with this tournament when you have that 2-8-year gap, when a lot of the kids are on the higher end and can't really return to the tournament. So we were lucky coming in this year that we actually had a decent amount. We are also lucky with the tournament of the U16 Eastern Challenges going on, that we do have a good group of guys coming up from that tournament that have experienced these types of tournaments before. So with all that going on, we do have a decent amount of guys that are coming from these competitions. So last year, Eastern Challenge, and last year's Canada Cup combined, it should be interesting to see what we can do.
So yet again, Nova Scotia is playing Ontario in the first game of the tournament.
Yep.
We know what happened last year. Bryce, can you talk about this matchup again? Can you talk about what preparation you may have done and what you're expecting from Team Ontario?
Honestly, I think you never really know what you're going to expect going into this tournament. You can kind of go to their roster and see what kids are doing, but schematically, you never really know. So preparation-wise, we're just kind of treating it kind of as any other opponent in this tournament. You can have a little bit of film here and there on the guys, but you're not really going to have a full game to watch what they've done offensively or defensively. But based on kind of our history with Team Ontario, we've played them the first game probably three times in my 5-year kind of experience in this tournament. So always exciting, always looking forward to kind of playing them. Me being from Ontario, I always look for that. And kind of, it'll be interesting. We'll see what we can do. I'm always expecting a high potent offense and defensive attack and special teams from them as well. So they're always going to be prepared. They're always going to be a fast-paced team. They got a lot of athletes in that province. So We'll see what we can do, but as I said, I mean, we're just looking to compete, and we're looking to compete with everybody in the tournament, from BC to Quebec to New Brunswick to Ontario, Sask, Manitoba, Alberta. We're looking to compete with all of them. That's kind of a period in our program, is just to compete, compete, compete.
If you could describe Team Nova Scotia in one word this year, what would it be and why?
Wow, that's a hard one. You're throwing at hard questions. I would say probably resiliency. Maybe in that sense, is just we're trying to get our guys to the point where they're battling and they're competing nonstop. Whether it's a get up moment where you think that you're injured or you're hurt, it's just get up, be resilient, move on to the next play. And that's kind of on both sides of the ball, and special teams is just compete to the end.
My final question for you, what are you personally most looking forward to at the 2018 Football Canada Cup?
Just playing. I mean, straight up, it's getting these kids the exposure that they deserve. We've been together for a long time. And these guys, it's all about kind of just getting them what they deserve, getting in front of the scouts that are going to be there, and just doing it on a national stage. I mean, you do this for, we've been together for a while now. We have the luxury of having a smaller province where we can do that. So at this point, being together for so long, we just want to get to that next stage where we're competing nationally. Our big thing is getting these guys the recognition that they deserve out in a small province where we're from.
Thank you, Bryce, for joining us.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Bryce Fisher, head coach of Team Nova Scotia. They are going to be competing at the Football Canada Cup in Calgary, Alberta.